you the opportunity to be the character you like, to act like one, to behave like one, to talk like one. It is a thing you could do in the hall, but, well, you know, making some Assassin's Creed stunts among other visitors might be a little bit dangerous. So, the stage gives you a lot of opportunities. You can perform in any genre you like. It can be a Disney fairy tale musical, a horror story, a vocal performance, or maybe, well, some epic anime movements. Anything is good. And, well, as you know, without the visitors, there would be no performance. Performance has its rules, and they should be followed. These rules are not written in the, well, basic kind of contest rules. Those rules are more like advice, something you need to do to make your performance look professional, to make it harmonic, and to make it interesting for the viewer. Always remember that you make performance for the viewers. Your main aim is to make emotions. The viewer should be happy or shiver with anticipation, be sad, whatever it is. If you get emotional response, then you succeeded. So let's start with basic performance tips. One, don't be shy. You already made it here. The main mistake many cosplayers make, so they come out for their performance, see the audience, and just go. I hope they don't see me. Hello. So don't be shy. Come to the front. Let the viewers and the jury see you, see your costume, show the best sides. So just to be confident. You already made it here. You deserve it. Also, a good tip is don't hurry. Once again, when you become shy, you want to leave the stage as fast as you can. So just... The thing is, take your time. Do the movements accurately and correctly. Show yourself. You might lose track of time due to all adrenaline that you get. Maybe recite a poem in your head. Just don't panic. Everything's fine. So the other good tip is make your movements bigger. In normal life, you point at something, well, like this. Size, they should be readable. So if you are walking, better not make it like this, but like this. Also, when you're pointing at someone, do it like this. If you're making a movement, use all of your body. Let the viewers see what you do. Rasengan. Next. It is... Sorry. Spoilers. So, this is a basic tip. Don't spend time with your back facing the audience. When you're standing like this, you are not interacting with anyone. You should do this only when you want to show some features of your costume, like lighting set or some embroidery on your back. But at the same time, don't lose the contact with people. Keep looking at them. Next. Like I said, your movements should be precise and readable. The thing is, a basic mistake. People come out, start making movements, and they do it like... and go away. The movements should be sharp. So, like, stand, take a second to show it. Next movement. Again, make it precise. Take your time and use the whole of your body. So next, keeping eye contact with the audience. It's similar to not turning your back, but Also, when people are panicking, when they are shy, they go out like this. Ooh, I lost my contact lens somewhere. So, keep eye contact. You don't have to look at the people. You can choose some spot on the behind their backs, but you should be facing it. Don't turn away. Don't try to hide. Everyone sees you. So next, mind the timing. Each convention, each competition has its own timing rules. It can be an 8-minute group performance, or it can be a 2.5-minute stage play, like in WCS, when you have to show everything in 2 minutes. Always use the timing for the best. If you have 2 minutes, there's no way you can fit the whole Naruto script in that timing. Better to show some really memorable moment from the anime. If you, on the contrary, if you have like 8 or 10 minutes, you should not start long dialogues between the characters. 8 minutes is enough time for a viewer to go outside and buy a hot dog, and the viewer will get that idea if he's bored. So try to keep the viewer interested during the whole time. Make him look at you, not turn away. So next one. Again, a basic mistake that people like to make small cosplay scenes about from a fandom that no one knows, but at the same time they want to show something that happened in that fandom. Well, through basic movements, like the character falls down and everyone should understand that he died because it happened in the anime. Not all people know your fandom, most don't. So it is better to stick to simpler schemes. Like one of my teachers once told me the KISS rule, K-I-A-S. Keep it simple, stupid. It just means that the plot should be understandable to everyone. When it should be understandable even to those who are not really into cosplay. So when you're making a performance, try showing it to your friends, try showing it to your colleagues or parents. Well, careful there. It should be interesting and understandable to everyone. Now next, you should check your sound quality. As you know, the sound on stage is much louder than it is on your laptop. So never try recording your voice on a laptop and putting it into the track. It is a bad idea. There will be other sounds. It might be screeching, but while listening on the laptop, you won't hear it. Better rent an audio recording studio or find a friend who is a musician or a video blogger and has the necessary equipment at home and make a clear and nice recording. I've seen many stage plays that were not readable just because you couldn't understand what the character was saying. So next, you should always check the technical characteristics of the stage in advance. For example, this one is a middle-sized stage with lighting equipment and a screen behind it. You can learn to use everything to your profit. Knowing the stage size, if you can install decorations, if you need a helper, if you can get up on the stage yourself. There are costumes that don't allow to use ladders, for example. Also, knowing the characteristics, you'll know what kind of lighting scheme you can ask for. Well, it all adds to your performance. Use it thank you. So this is what I was talking about. Usually there is a special script for lighting and special effects where you write what kind of lighting you need. Do you need fume or something else? I really advise you to write it if there is such opportunity from the organizers. So next, act until the end, which means be your character until you leave the stage. So while you are here, you should behave like the character and leave the stage like the character. If you are performing as a barbarian, then live like this. So don't think that your performance ends when the music ends. You take a bow, then continue playing. Just when you are not visible to people, then it's okay. You may stop. I have a funny story about this. Once there was a performance, a girl was performing as Jessica Rabbit. The whole performance was very nice. She was all seductive and beautiful. So she ended, comes to the curtain, but the video operator follows her. So people can still see that she's leaving. She takes one step behind the curtain. Well, that was funny, but you see what I mean. The other thing, but it was more about the technical side of the performance. A person was giving a vocal performance, something very lyrical and touching. In the end, she leaves the stage. And she hasn't handled the microphone to the crew, and she says something that, without the offensive language, translated as, "Oh my God, I wet my pants over there." Well, you see, be careful with the microphones. So, next, make your costume suitable for your performance. If you are planning to do some stunts, maybe it is better to omit some details that will prevent you from making the movements or that can just break and fall down. But at the same time, you should make your decision based on the judging criteria, because some performances like Euro cosplay are more focused on the costume accuracy. The other contests might be focused on performance. So you should always know what you are aiming at, making a cool performance or showing a cool costume. It's very hard to combine both a cool costume and a performance. We know that gaming designs are not very, cannot exactly be shown in reality. So next, don't panic. Even if everything goes wrong, if they lost your audio track, if they lost your script for special effects, if the lighting operator has a hangover and is messing up everything, if you forgot your words, don't panic. It's all okay. We're not professionals, we're amateurs, and we are here to be better, to become better, to learn to do something new. Even if you screwed up everything, you can return to the stage and show the new performance. If next time it goes well, everyone will forget that you screwed up. Trust me. I screwed up well, like no one, believe me. So next, we're moving to group performance tips. The group performance, a performance of several people on stage, usually more than two. And the keyword will be teamwork. A team should consist of people who are really motivated to do this performance, who do it because they're enthusiastic and they want it. You should all act together. When you're making a group performance from a large number of people, pay attention to arranging people on the stage. It's not good when a group of 10 people is situated on one square meter in the corner of the stage and they do it for the whole time of their performance. Just try to place them harmoniously so that it is readable and the audience can see all of you. Next, everyone on stage should be kept busy, which means each person should know his or her role. So no standing apart from others, picking your nose, checking Facebook. You should know what to do. Even keeping a pose is considered busy. Next, during group performances, never leave the stage empty. If one person is leaving, the other person should appear straight away. This way, the viewer will be interested. If the stage is empty, attention is lost. No matter how beautiful your soundtrack is, you'll lose the viewers. Well, the only thing you can, the only condition you can leave the stage empty is when you are using the screen and there is something going on it. Next, stage fights. I'd say stage fights is a separate category of group performances. A good stage fight can put your performance to the top, give you the first place. But a bad stage fight can make it hilarious and make you lose all the points. Making a stage fight, you should have some basic knowledge of how to handle your props, of how to act, and to, of course, to rehearse a lot. Just keep rehearsing, and the good tip is rehearsing at twice bigger speed than you are, well, intending to do it on stage. So next I wanted to show you a small performance, parts of my performance with the WTF Cos Band. We made our group performance on Shingeki no Kyojin. It is a good example of placing people, dividing them into groups, and making these groups interact with each other. So could you please start the video?
Part.
we prepared this performance for half a year. We hired a choreographer to help us with the dancing parts. But it was a great experience for me, and that's where I learned about things like making movements bigger and more precise and things like that. The other video I wanted to show you is actually a stage fight by our Russian team. So two good schemes for a stage fight is a fight with full contact, when people actually hit each other, but it requires very durable props and armor. And the other scheme is when people don't hit each other, but there is the sound of weapons clinging and hitting each other. So this is a video of Sword Art Offline Duet, one of their performances. They always do excellent stage fights in different genres. So could you please start the second video? The thing you should also know, a good stage fight requires a lot of, you should be fit for it. Because after 2 minutes of a good stage fight, you'll feel exhausted like you did a 5 kilometer run, I think. So, next. We are moving to, a small picture of us carrying away the decorations. And then, solo performance tips. This is the case when you are alone on stage. And most likely you'll face the problem that the stage is big and you are small. You have to occupy it and to draw attention to you. So we'll focus on the ways of filling the stage. So, the first is action. Make your performance very lively. Make a lot of movement. Everything you can. Show yourself, draw attention to you, keep running, keep changing directions, movements, and so on. Then you won't need anything else. You won't need decorations, effects, and so on. You will yourself be the center of performance. The next, obvious way to fill the stage are decorations. Again, check the stage requirements. If the stage is big, you can place decorations. But the drawback is that good decorations require a separate budget. And it may exceed the budget of your costume, as decorations are bigger. No decoration is better than a bad one. So always pay attention to it. A good decoration can make your performance very, very atmospheric. Also, screen animation. It's like the way I'm showing my presentation right now, when something happens in the background. But be careful with it. It might draw too much attention to itself. It is good to use it as a background, but it should not act on its own. So you shouldn't combine a vocal performance, a dance, and an AMV going on the back. You'll better choose choose one way of drawing attention. Next, using other people. There are some contests let solo performers have their helpers on stage. This way they can organize, for example, moving decorations, or a helper can control some radio-controlled prop from behind the stage. It is also a good way. Keep that in mind. Lightning and fume effects. Like I said, always have a separate script for lightning, for effects, for the crew. So this way, your performance can be much more atmospheric. Huge costume that's hard to move in. So I just started the performance with small steps, making it look like it is very hard to wear it. It's a fake. I can wear it okay. And to make it more lively, I switched the theme in the end and started these robotic movements. It's just switching your track, your music, is also a good way to drawing attention to yourself. So the next video I want to show you is my Euro cosplay performance. The stage was similar to this one, so there was room for decorations, but the problem was that transferring them to another city, that's almost impossible. So I decided to rely on action once again. The thing is, I was very stressed. It was the first time I performed abroad, and presenting your country, well, that's huge responsibility. And I faced the problem when I could not remember what to do. A good tip is using the method of Palace of Memory. You might have heard of it. It is normally used just to memorize something, but it can also be used on stage. So if you're stressing out, start making some hilarious associations with what you do. Like here, I was performing as Kalista, I had to remember my scheme like this. So, okay, let's imagine I am entering a game. I'm making three steps, looking to the right. I see that no one picked bot. Okay, I make another step, turn left. No one picked top. So then I'm disappointed and I take mid. Well, that's like a League of Legends humor, but still. I think I had a kind of jump, and I remembered it as, oh my god, there's Teemo in the bushes. Oh, like this, I memorized the whole performance, and it was okay. not a perfect one, but at least I had my scheme in my mind. So could you please start the last video?
Our partner event in Russia is PanicCon. And coming up on stage now, we have Alex Reese as Blood Moon Callista from the League of Legends.
We had a name once. Callista. Yes. We trusted. Why?
You see, a quite dramatic performance, but having all these, well, hilarious associations in my head kept me focused. So it distracted me from panicking. And well, you see, it's not visible from the outside what happens in my head. Well, let's move to dangers of the stage performance. Things you should know. The keyword here is safety. Your performance should be safe for others. So the first one, warn the organizers if you're using bulk material like confetti, glitters, or something. It makes the stage slippery. So it's dangerous for the Gundam who comes out next. Then, these lamps are called soffits. Don't throw anything near them. They are very hot. And you may start a fire if you throw some paper inside. Be careful with that. Also, if your costume broke, you lost something on the stage, immediately ask a stage volunteer to find it. Someone, again, may accidentally step on it. Some costumes have low visibility, and a participant might step on it, slip, fall down. Well, emergency, ambulance. And an obvious one, don't use liquids and open fire on stage. I once saw a beautiful performance of my friends, but they made a mistake. They used flashes, sparkles flying out of their hands. It looked beautiful, but they got disqualified. And unfortunately, I'm with organizers on this one. The performance must be safe. So, the most important rule of all, have fun. Otherwise, it has no meaning. And now, I would like to show a small performance that I performed that I prepared for today. Just another example of solo performance with no decorations. And I need help to put on my hands. Okay. You may turn off the microphone when I'm ready to start the track.
Yeah.